I was doing some nice little motions to the camera. They can hear you now, by the way, Noah. Good morning, everybody.
Oh, they can. That's nice, huh? Good morning.
Good
How we
morning.
Doing?
When the podcast works as expected.
Wow. Look at us go.
Awesome. Yeah, we're doing so great. We're doing so, so great. So, Noah, how are you on this fine morning?
Doing pretty good. It's a wonderful Wednesday morning.
Yeah, it is. It's been raining
it's
all
actually,
day here.
No, it's not raining here. It's just so hot. Like, hold on.
Oh.
Alexa, what is the temperature outside right now? We're gonna find out. 85.
That's so weak.
But the humidity is like 95%. Yeah. Alexa, what is the humidity outside?
Right now, the humidity is
68%.
Oh.
Well, 68%. For those of you who didn't hear it, it's 85 degrees and it's 65% humidity, and this man is complaining.
Because it was, okay, because the day before it was like 50 degrees, so it was cool. And now all of a sudden...
Well, yeah. Share that weather, bro. That's no fair. I want that.
I want it to be like 75, no humidity, perfect fall weather.
Yeah, it will be in fall. It's still early September. We're just now getting off hell's front porch here in the Midwest.
Yeah. Well, what are you going to do?
It was 105 last Tuesday here.
How was your morning there, Kyle Tupper?
Well, I've said good morning a couple times on the podcast. It has not been a good morning. So I shout out to our boys over there at Roasted Gems Coffee and Area iRacing. Your coffee's great. I got a bag of the Cinnabon stuff. I love it. The small caveat is I was trying to set up my coffee maker, right? Just a nice little Black & Decker Cafe Noir. It's over there on my desk. You guys can't see it.
Yeah. Of course.
So I was trying to plug it in and... my dumbass bumped the desk a little bit too hard. And also, I was intelligent enough to leave the bag of coffee, like the ground coffee, wide open. So here, you know what? I'll grab it for you. This thing, this beautiful bag of coffee right here, is now half as full as it was when I got it. And it's not because I've made half of the bag.
It's because half the bag's on the floor.
Half of the bag found its way onto my floor right in front of my desk.
I mean, at least your room smells pretty good
now. It does actually smell delectable, I'm not gonna lie. It smells really good. But
your room smells like a coffee shop.
Yeah, I'm also not afraid to admit I just Swiffered last night. I might have just scooped up most of the coffee and put it back in the bag.
Oh my gosh. Hey, you have to do what you have to do.
I was gonna say, like, I'm a college kid. I paid like $20 for this coffee. Actually, I don't think it's that much. I think it's a lot cheaper than that. But we used code Area iRacing for 10% off. But yeah, I mean,
or is it Area iRacing? And then isn't it the another one? What's the team that uses them?
Oh, was it Lucky Ducks?
Lucky Ducks, or Scioli.
Yeah, so it might be. It's either code Scioli, it could be code Lucky Ducks, it could be code We Are Lucky Ducks. I don't remember, but yeah, definitely shout out to them. Go get your Roasted Gems coffee. It's really good, even off the floor. Also,
yes,
Noah, do you have experience with a coffee maker?
Yes, kind of.
Do you use coffee filters?
Yes.
I did not.
So you got ground all up in your coffee.
No, it really wasn't that bad. It's still pretty smooth. I thought it still tasted pretty good.
Yeah, it really just filters out for ground, like big grounds.
Yeah, no, it wasn't awful. I just mixed it up nice and stirred it, and it was still pretty yummy. It tasted a little bit like Swiffer Sweeper soap, but
yeah,
it was like a smoothie. Yummy. Yeah, yeah, it's like a
smoothie.
Nice...
Yeah.
Oh, dude, this place on campus here at Purdue. The Third Street Market has these, they're like frozen cups, and you take them out of the freezer in the market. You take the lid off. You put them into this machine that blends them.
Is it the for real machine?
Yes.
Yes.
Dude, oh my god, for real machine. Oh, it's so good. What's your favorite one, Noah?
Okay, no. So this is big news. The gas station next to our Napa got one yesterday.
Hell yeah! Have you tried it yet?
No,
dude,
I just saw
so
them
good.
Installing it. Oh
they're
my gosh, I'm so excited now.
They're so delicious. We've had it for like a year, I think, but I was just now open to the possibility of trying it. I realized how bust delicious it was.
I went in there yesterday to the gas station after work, and I saw them installing it. I'm like, what in the world is this thing? And then I just heard you talking about it. That's insane.
It's so scrumptious.
That's awesome.
It is so yummy. I don't know why that came to my head to talk about that, but that does not taste like Swiffer Sweeper soap. That tastes delicious. No, I got the cotton candy one.
Yeah.
Cotton candy is so fire, dude. They've got a peanut butter cup one that looks pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty scrumdiddlyumptious, honestly. So I would recommend it. Shout out to Roasted Gems Coffee and For Real. We've already done two plugs, so it's sponsor us, ?
Yeah, For Real sponsor us. That'd be a pretty cool car, to be honest.
The For Real car would be dope.
You could do a different flavor every week.
I'm going to have to send him an email. I'm going to have to send For Real an email. Maybe they'll send me like a coupon or something.
That's all we need.
This is all I'm asking for in my life is a For Real sponsorship. So in the off chance that one of our 36 viewers is the marketing director at For Real.
For Real. Shut us up, please.
I see what you did there, For Real. That was clever.
That's pretty good.
But yeah, so I spilled my coffee. That significantly put a damper on things this morning. I think I've been smoothly sailing other than that, but just ain't the way I want to start. And I'm getting a cold. I'm getting all stuffy.
And it is that time of year. Everyone's getting sick around me.
Bro,
so far I'm good.
The temperature dips below 80 degrees and my nose just decides to clog.
That's the worst. At least it doesn't. Does it bleed? Mine sometimes bleeds with the
temperature. I get nosebleeds when it's dry, in summer.
Same. It's the worst.
Yeah, I'm good at that. Speaking of nosebleeds, I'm sure your nose bled when you got hit by a vehicle a while ago.
Well, yeah. So we'll start with that one. A while ago, I guess we can go quickly into the accident story. Kate Duff and I are about to do a race. Suzuka, like the big long one, 12-hour. It was like the night before, two days before, I got into a pretty nice, decent-sized car accident. I was heading to a different Napa store in Middletown, Connecticut. Came to a four-way intersection, went straight through, as you would at a green light, like a normal person. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, this lady just comes barreling through the red light and just absolutely totals the car I was in. And I ended up tearing my meniscus. I had a pretty decent sized concussion, so my knee was all messed up, so I really couldn't function with the gas pedal correctly, so I was out for the race.
It was so weird, though. The night it happened, you came back and you're like, I feel fine. Like, I'll be okay.
Yeah.
I was like, what? And then, there's no chance.
I think it was just so much adrenaline.
Yeah, that's exactly it. Adrenaline?
Adrenaline. It's
there
fine.
You go.
But then the next morning I woke up and I was like, dude, I am not good.
Jesus. Yeah. I was like, there's no way this kid's still alive right now.
The car that I was in got totaled, which was, it wasn't an old Napa delivery car. This thing was brand new. We'd gotten it a week before, brand new from the dealership. The car had 2,000 miles on it. It was a brand new car and it totaled.
Damn.
It was really upsetting.
Do you get a 4X for it?
Yeah. But it wasn't my fault, though. That's the thing. Like, iRacing in there, like, they hand out this penalty to everyone, even though, like, I was going through the green light, and she just absolutely flies through. And then she gets out of the car. She's like, I thought I had the green.
Nope.
I'm like,
I looked up. You look at the light, still red. Like,
yeah, I see that. I didn't know. So she admitted her fault to the cop, so I didn't get in any trouble or anything, but...
Shout out.
That was just crazy. And then yesterday morning, I thought I was actually on my way to work yesterday, I thought my life was gonna be over. It was really one of the scarier. It was close to an accident, but it wasn't an accident. Just got my morning Dunkin'.
I want to interject. I was just gonna say
I was going on my way to work. I was passing like their local high school and then Hebron, Connecticut. And all of a sudden I see like it was still like kind of dusk because I go into work pretty early. Or like morning, dawn, sorry. And obviously it's two headlights in my oncoming lane coming straight at me. And it's not like there was anybody. It's not like he was going around anybody in his lane because I was like looking at his lane to see if there's like a biker or a walker walking to school. But no, this guy was just coming straight at me, oncoming, just like pretty fast too. And I'm honking my horn like, dude, you got to get out of my lane. And like I'm at this point pulled up into this person's lawn. So like there's like a lawn, like someone lives across from the high school. I pull up onto this person's lawn. So this person's like not going to hit me. As he's getting like pretty close, I'd say within 20 feet, he finally notices. I think he was on his phone or something. He jolts back into his lane and just continues flying down the road.
Me it and iRacing.
I was just like, holy crap, dude. I almost just got into a head-on collision.
Excellent. Yeah. Well, yeah, our topic sheet here literally just says Noah almost died times two. So
now I can't hear you.
I wondered if you couldn't hear me. You were literally... I can't hear anything. Yes, I know you can't hear me. You were talking over me for like 20 seconds. All right, fellas, we're back. Noah, do you want to explain what happened?
So, I must have pressed something on the keyboard. It muted the sound. That's all.
Yeah, you muted your PC is what happened. So, now I have to go do editing work again.
But what was your reaction?
My reaction was, I was laughing the whole time, and I was like, you were mid-story, and I was like yelling at you, because you kept talking. I was like, I want to interject and make a point and say something, and you just kept going. I'm like, this bitch is just talking right over me. He's being a dickhead. I just wanted to do my part and say something, and this dude just keeps talking, and I was like yelling. Like, I was raising my voice like, Noah, shut the fuck up. And then you just kept going.
What was your point?
I just thought it was funny how it just says Noah died times two on the game.
So that was our plan.
Yeah, that was our plan, dude. That was interesting for sure. Thank you for plugging your headphones back in.
I considered calling the cops because I was like, I don't know if this
about
guy's on.
The headphones or about the guy in your lane.
The guy in my lane that almost just ended my life.
Yeah. Well, we would have had a nice cum-filled funeral for you if it happened.
That would have been pretty awesome.
It would have been cum everywhere. Just like you liked it.
All right, moving right along.
No, I kind of like the cum. Conversation was nice.
Conversation?
Yeah.
Is there some drama going on there, Kyle?
Well, there was. I don't know if there really is anymore. There will be when we have our owners meeting, but shout out to Aria. Anybody who's watching, yeah, we're talking shit again. Don't worry, it's what we do.
This is indeed what we do.
So in the good old Aria team owner room, there's been some chaos going on. Any of you guys who are just drivers in Aria, you don't know about the team owner room. Shit goes down in the team owner room. But we were just discussing the likelihood and or possibility and or possible solutions for reserve drivers in Aria. So the way Aria works is you have your charters, you have your amount of charters, you can have up to four. And as of now, it's one driver per charter. So you don't get to have any reserves or subs. If they can't make a race, they can't make a race. Because of that, team points are structured so only your top two finishers in each race from a team, only your top two charter drivers score points for you. True. So a lot of the team owners want some kind of reserve driver and or substitute system. They think that as long as you run like the same number for a charter, you can switch drivers. And there's a lot of middle ground in there. Obviously, that's the extreme of that end. And there are lots of sides of the argument. But no, I'd just be interested to hear your opening thoughts while I gather mine.
I don't know. It's a really interesting topic. And then like, you can see really both sides of the argument because like, a lot of people say it's unfair because you can just bring in, say, a road course expert for the road course and just say your other driver's sick or something, and you can gain that competitive advantage. But other people are like, yeah, but we're all cool here. That's not going to happen. We just want to have someone just in case someone quits or someone's unreliable. So I can see both sides of it.
Let me interject as well. You made the point of, like, we're all cool here, and that point was made in the owner room. And then one of the team owners literally said, if this rule's put into place, I'm going to abuse it. Like, straight up said that.
Yeah.
Which is, again, fair. Like, if the rules put in place and you're given that leeway within the rules to score more points, that's your job to score points. There's money on the line here.
It's in the rules. It's not cheating.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's racing. That always has been racing. But I just, especially with us only being given two charters last year, it's almost impossible for us to compete with the four car teams.
Because they have four opportunities to finish higher than us with two.
Yeah, so two of their drivers have an off day, and two of them have a good day. They're still scoring better more than us. Two of our drivers have an off day, we're scoring 20 Nothing. Points. And they're scoring 40, 50, 60, which really adds up. So, like, you add in a reserve driver, and I'm hoping we'll have four charters next year, so it won't be an issue. You throw in a reserve driver. Yeah. You throw in a reserve driver for them, and then they have two drivers that have an off day, one driver that can't make it, and one driver that has a good day. Usually, you're screwed, as you should be, because you have four chances to score points. If you can't show up at least 50% of your drivers, then it's tough shit, man. Like, tough shit. Sorry. But you have four drivers contracted. You know that you're supposed to run the whole season. Yeah. And even if just two of them show up, it's fine. You're still full strength. You're still scoring the maximum amount of team points you can. And you want a fifth? So you can have 20% attendance and still be safe instead of 25? That's what you want? I don't know.
It's really tough because, like, everyone knew, like you said, will abuse it. And, like, I understand why some people want it, but at the same time, it's just like, when you sign the drivers, you have to make sure that, like, we only had a driver miss one race this whole season. That was because Steve was getting engaged.
Yeah.
And when we signed them, we knew that they'd be committed.
Yep. And again, Hartman, he had a fair point. I feel bad for him. He was like, two of my drivers flaked, like, four races into the season. A couple and things I'll say there. I don't know Logan Hartman, so I have respect for the guy. I don't know what he's like or what his team operation is like. There's no reason that should realistically happen. Either you just found a driver in an iRacing public lobby and signed him up, or there was something wrong with the team culture that was enjoyable. And either way, you get two drivers that drop out, you still have two drivers to participate the rest of the season. You still can meet that 50% attendance. There's no problem with that. And 50% is the minimum that you can have to keep your charter. But again,
all you need. And even if they showed up for the first race, you technically, the two wouldn't even show up for every single race if all four showed up for the first race.
Yeah, I mean, that's why with our new contracts, we have a clause that says, if you stop showing up to races, you are paying us. You're paying us a release clause if you stop showing up. Yeah, which is pretty
much their entry fees back.
Yeah. Give us the money back that we earned. So, and that would discourage that. And we also, I think we treat our drivers pretty well. We give them incentives to race. We give them finishing bonuses. And again, maybe not every team does that, and that's fine. I don't expect every team to run their team like a big business that, because it's sim racing. It is what it is. But you can't complain when you're still having the possibility to earn full points, still having two drivers out of your four. And you can't complain if you just grabbed a couple guys and said, hey, run this season with me, and then they stop showing up, and they're not under any kind of contract or anything. There's nothing binding them to that. There's really nothing you can do
at that point. What Connor wanted to do was a little bit more interesting. He had a couple of friends that can't do the whole season, but he wanted to have them share that because, like, they have different work commitments.
Yeah, tough shit.
That's his in real life friends. That's a different. I feel like that's a slightly different situation.
I feel like that's worse. I think that's worse. Worse? Then you're doing it to gain a competitive advantage. Then you're not doing it because people can't show up. You're not doing it because of something that's out of your control. You're doing it because you want to score more points.
No, it's because they can't show up. So his friends, like, they can only show up to certain races, but the other ones that it's two friends that can show up to only a certain amount of races.
Yeah, so you want to sign two part-time drivers instead of a full-time driver is what you want to do.
Yeah, yeah, but because they can only show up to so many.
And who says... I think that's different. Yeah, how do we verify that those two drivers are actually not able to be there, or he's not just cherry-picking whichever one is best at a certain track? Because then you essentially have five charters is what you have.
You got to pay for five charters.
It doesn't matter, though. I don't care if you're paying. Like, then why is it a four-team field?
If,
Why don't we just let every team have five drivers then?
You can if you have the option.
Yeah, not even call it a reserve. Just say you can straight up run five every race.
No, just have four and everyone gets a reserve.
Yeah.
If one person gets it, then everyone can have it.
Yeah, I guess. But then you got two charter teams, or three charter teams. Then do you have to sell an additional charter for that fifth driver, or do you just add it on?
It's no, because he's not. It's only still four charters. It's just you have the additional sub that you pay for.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just, like, I get it, but Area's all about, like, attendance. So I get it. I guess you will keep attendance up if you allow teams to run part-time, so that's fine. And there would have to be
the other guy was saying, too, it's only a one-time thing. He can't ever do it again. Who was saying that? It was, like, Dom, I think.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I just feel like it's a you give an inch, you take a mile kind of thing. Like, you give them one reserve driver, okay. Yeah. Then they're going to start asking for a reserve driver for every driver. Then they're going to start asking to just fully run, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 charters per team. And then they pick their best four for every race. Like, yeah. Because then you're getting into the realm where it's not going to be affordable for anyone anymore. And just the teams with the most money are going to win. Which, for that to happen in a sim racing league, that should not be happening.
No.
I don't think. But, yeah, I don't know.
It's going to be interesting. Yeah.
Because I'm like...
See how the votes pile up.
We just as easily go grab Jeff Wright, because he's on call some days, but he's off call some days.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
We go ahead and grab Jeff Wright and bring him in for a few races,
because we know he's good
at certain tracks.
Yeah, and that'd be fine.
Yeah.
If it's voted on.
Yeah. I don't know. It doesn't fit the competitive spirit of the league right now is what I think. But I guess that's up for the owners to decide.
But we don't actually... we have to see if... it really all depends. But if they can come up with a good way to implement it.
Yeah. They also said it's difficult with Sim Racer Hub, which would be a major stumbling block for that.
I said we all have to choose from like a certain pool of drivers that we all predetermined before the end of the beginning of the season, so we all know who the like it's like a group of five drivers that are available on those nights that we all know and agree upon between all the teams. So then they like so it can't be some secret weapon.
Yeah, that's interesting too. I like that idea. Yeah, I think the biggest issue is bringing in like a specific road course driver, which is what
people do. Yeah. I think if it's like a predetermined between every tone owner agreed on group, of like a five that are available on those different nights, like say each like a truck series has a group of five they choose from, Xfinity series and Cup series, and then they can all agree on a certain group of people, that could be a sub if you needed one for that night, and then you could choose one of those five for that night. I feel like that's a better way that it's not as much of a competitive advantage because every team has the same option of people.
Right. Yeah, there's a lot of manipulation that can go on there. Yeah. And like I said, it's a give an inch, you take a mile kind of thing. Like, Area starts allowing that, and all of a sudden people are going to start asking for more and more and more, and it's just going to become a mess. But I think it could potentially be a good thing, and it definitely would help teams that just straight up have guys that can't show up.
Can't show up, because then they could just get one of those guys each week if they really needed to.
Yeah.
Or we have a certain amount of limit. We could limit the amount of uses you can use those subs, say once or twice.
That's what I said. I said like you can use three races. Use a reserve driver three times.
But I do like the idea of it all being a group of agreed upon people. That's why it's less like you can go find a road course master out there for a certain week.
Yeah.
Okay, well, like moving on.
Somebody said one more thing. Somebody said like you've got a pool of free agent drivers that aren't chartered. They're just in driving to drive and be free agents.
Yeah, so you choose one of them
for a race. Yeah.
Yeah. One of the people that are already there that opened the driver that week. Yeah. Yep. Like Spencer last week. Yeah.
Right.
Last year, per se. We could just pick him up for a race when Steven was out. Exactly. Say that.
Yep. Anyway.
Wow.
We waffled for a while about that. Yeah.
Yeah. What do I move on to here?
What you choose, Noah. You choose.
I feel like we're already in the iRacing side of things. Let's continue with that before we move on to real life stuff.
Okay.
So we could talk about the new Super Duper the Formula, or I should just say Super Formula car that's being added into iRacing.
Those were some words. Yeah, it looks pretty. Looks gorgeous.
It is. It does look pretty gorgeous. I feel like that's gonna be a fun series. I know. I think it's. What?
Oh, I'm just gonna say I was gonna obliterate someone in turn one in Monza with that thing.
I think it's gonna be a B license car. That probably makes sense. But
well, no, I guess we're getting our B licenses.
Or we can just do some private lobbies with it. It does look fun.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm pretty excited for that car. iRacing has been adding a lot of new stuff recently, so that's pretty exciting.
Yeah, they're on a tear right now. When are we getting rain? That's my question.
They've been working on weather models, I know.
They've
but...
been working on weather models since the dawn of time. They've teased it rain every single season.
It needs to be perfect.
Yeah. Excellent. It's like the rain that we had in the set of Corsa for Formula Dream.
That was the most...
We should talk about Formula Dream as well.
Yeah, we could quickly bounce off of that.
Well, we'll just touch on the Xfinity cars also got the new damage model, so that'll be interesting for the new area season. While we're still
that'll be pretty fun. Yeah, that will be cool. It's going to change a lot because it hasn't been updated in a while, so that's going to be making racing a little bit better, I assume.
Hopefully.
I sure do hope so.
Battle for 20 minutes is going to heat up big time.
Let's go, Steven.
Go, Steve.
Also coming up on the weekend of the 16th, we're doing the Bathurst 1000. I feel like that's an announcement. Well, I guess we didn't even announce that. I guess this is us announcing that right now. That's pretty crazy. We haven't said anything about that. So I guess that's the announcement. We're doing the Bathurst 1000.
We're celebrating 1 year since our first official iRacing race.
Do we know who our third driver is for that yet?
That's a good question. I want to run two teams, honestly.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
If we have guys, because Michal and guys like that have offered to drive.
Yeah. That we could do two teams. It'd be cool to do a come A, come B.
Yeah. We could even, maybe we can have enough for three. I don't know. But we can see, see if Casey, Steven, Spencer, if they want to do it.
Yeah, and I can hit up our old friend to see if he wants to run.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it should be really interesting.
Cool.
That track is wicked. So.
We just need to, we'll have to find one more that actually runs with us. And then, we can definitely do two or three teams.
Yep.
That'd be
cool.
See,
we do have an advantage if we bring in a guy like Michal, too, because he's European. So he's on that time zone. So he could run an early stint. And then, some guys come in and join.
Yeah, that is true. That'd be cool.
But yeah.
We did. It's like 3 hours a piece around that, I think.
Yeah, throwback to when James Brown binned that car like 20 times.
I got home from work and I just got it in such bad condition. I remember just looking at that car and I was like, holy crap, what happened to this thing?
Yeah. What did we end up finishing? Like 20th?
No, 12th.
12th? See, that ain't bad. 12th. That ain't bad.
I remember before the race, I was like, we're going to finish decently. And then we actually got 12th. I was actually pretty happy with it.
Yeah. Well, we should have been higher up than that, honestly. Like, literally, if we just would have gone 5 seconds per lap slower and just like, car and not crash, we would have been just as good.
I think I'm down to practice for a bit after this, if you're down. Just to get some feel for it again.
We have to do Formula Dream, Noah.
After that.
I have to eat lunch.
No one needs lunch these days.
You have homework.
Yeah, but that's fine. I looked at it, and it's actually not due till the 17th.
Oh, so. Bad. Okay. Good. Yeah, we can do that after I eat lunch.
Yeah. Valid. We have until 5 o'clock. I have a class. And then we can always go after class, too. Class is until 7:15.
Yes.
It's a 2-hour class.
I have a meeting from 6 to 9 and I have to go somewhere at 3:22. But...
6 to 9, funny number.
We'll have fun. We'll have fun. We'll be okay.
Super duper. And they stole our flow on the announcement.
They did. The Super Formula stole our entire flow word for word, bar for bar, with their Japanese theme, like we did for Suzuka. Now, to be fair, we didn't have a running race because Noah got hit by a car, but...
That is a true statement.
Yeah.
And you got a concussion the next day, if I remember correctly.
Oh, yeah. Similar. I did have a concussion. That's right. I hurt myself playing soccer. Yeah, I did have a concussion for the race.
So we were doing really good.
Yeah, we're doing really great. We're going to do better this year. But yeah, hopefully we can get the car home in one piece for Bathurst.
Well, I'll continue on the discussion of virtual side before I move to F1 then. So we'll quickly touch on last week's Formula Dream race.
God, it was wild. Well, we're recording this, too, Wednesday morning. We're going to Interlagos for the Brazilian
tonight.
Grand Prix in, 30 minutes.
Well, tonight. It's tonight, but 30 minutes.
Well, Actually, it will, have been, after... it will have been 6 hours ago when this video goes up. But
when this goes up, yeah.
But yeah.
At least I didn't make you do too much editing today, other than my mic, slight mic and problem.
I'll just have to join the videos together.
I'm going to have you put the finish of the race right here.
Literally nothing entertaining happened at the finish.
No.
I don't even think we saw Brown crossing the
finish line. Can you put a compilation of all the different times they all got called into pits?
Absolutely. That would take me like an hour.
No, I'm kidding. But that did happen. They all got called into pits.
They did get called into pits.
19 times on the last... there was cars getting called into pits on the last lap and they went in. I was like, what is going on here?
It was Barahona. It was Barahona. Got called in like three separate times. He was in P3. He got called in
four times.
Ended up P6. And like half the field and ended up a lap down because it was pissing down rain for the last half of the race.
Shout out to Jedi John not finishing the first race again.
Yeah, shout out to a Jedi John DNF. It's starting to become a theme. It's been a theme for two seasons now, and we're on season two. So
he's doing pretty good.
Yeah, he's doing excellent.
If you guys didn't see the new intro and all the new scenes and everything are absolutely beautiful for Formula Dream this season.
Yes, and I'm not going to show them to you because you should come and watch the races. So at this point, the next race will be, I believe, Indianapolis. It'll be on Sunday around noon. And then after that, it'll be the next Wednesday, 8 p.m. We go to Avis. So be there.
And if you can't catch them, live, you can also find them right on our YouTube channel, full VOD of the whole race.
Good words.
You were cutting me off like 18 different times.
I didn't even say anything that time. I didn't say a word.
You did.
I was just waiting for you.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
You're so mean to me. I'm gonna go get Daisy. You're gonna go get your dog. Why are you going to get your dog? Why are you leaving me alone to do the podcast?
Daisy wants to be on the podcast.
She can't even see.
She can see out of one eye.
She can barely see.
She can almost see. Fine. Next time.
Okay. Excellent. Yeah, she won't even know what's going on. Like Daisy on the podcast. She'll just throw up on the. She's like, "Why am I in the air?
Why am I in the air?" Yeah, but she can get her first podcast.
Excellent. This is the Daisy. This is the Daisy episode. You know what? Go get her. We need a name for the podcast title, so we're gonna call it the Daisy episode. So go get the dog.
I'm gonna go get Daisy.
This is gonna be the Daisy episode. That's fine. Anybody who's an audio listener, I'm so sorry. God, why is Noah built like that? Anyway. Anyone who's an audio-only listener, I'm sorry, you're going to miss out on this Daisy content. Shout out to Spotify. They let us upload videos instead of just audio podcasts. That's kind of lit of them. My hair actually looks kind of bust-alicious right now. I'm not going to lie. Kind of cute. Oh, there she is. That's a good girl. Yes, it is officially the Daisy episode now.
Daisy, look at you.
Look at her. Noah can't hear me, but I'm going to ask him which eye she can actually see out of when he puts the headset back on.
I can hear you. What's up?
Oh, sweet. Which one, which eye can she actually see out of?
So, here. See how... Oh, Daisy, look at the camera. See how this one's all clouded up on this side?
Yeah.
She can't see out of that one. She can see out of this one on this side.
That makes sense. All right, excellent. Good.
All right, Daisy, you're going to go over here now.
Good Daisy content. She's becoming your interior decoration now. I hope she shits on your bed.
You just go to sleep. Good girl. Just go to sleep.
It'd be really funny if she just pissed on your bed right now. Aw, she sat down. Look at her go. All
right.
Taking 5 minutes away from our podcast to talk about your dog.
All right, cool. Moving on now. We got a new background.
Yeah, we do have a new background. Excellent.
What's going on? F1 discussion. That's what you have on the schedule.
Yeah, I have like nothing to talk about with F1.
It was a pretty boring race overall. Yeah. I mean, I can be totally honest. Nothing really happened to you. I was excited for Ferrari for like 5 minutes, and then it just got ruined.
Yeah, so. I was so hard at the start of the race because I was like, shit, Ferrari's gonna have a 1-2 at their home race, and then Max just went
did Max,
and then it was over.
Yeah. It wasn't even close.
Yeah.
So that was kind of just that. Yeah.
We were kind of in the middle of talking about Formula Dream, though, actually.
I'm sorry, Daisy. You ruined that.
No. We can go back to it. It's fine. We're nearing the 40-minute mark anyway, so.
Oh, we're at a pretty good time.
We're at a pretty good time. But we can talk a little bit more about Formula Dream. And because we're going to Interlagos. No, I don't know if you remember that race from last year. Some guy named Kyle Tupper won it.
Yeah, because he cheated.
I did not cheat.
Some people thought you did.
Some people actually did think I cheated. Those people are no longer with us, so... they're not dead. They're not dead, sorry. That sounded like they
were dead. It sounded like you killed the dude.
Yeah.
What are you looking at, dude?
Can you pay attention to the podcast, please? not the dog. She's cute, but... Come on, now.
All right.
Interlagos, Noah. Do you think IEC is going to win?
Probably.
I think IEC is going to win. I think they're having a good season. I think they're going to be lit. Their car's yellow and green. How could they possibly lose? Why did you just go red?
All right, because I just opened the Google Chrome page. It's red.
Oh, that's awesome. Sexy mood lighting. I love it.
It is kind of nice.
Over under on amount of times Jedi John crashes today?
2.
Over under 1.5? You're taking the over? I'll take the under.
Yeah.
I'll take the under on that. I think it'll be once. I don't think it'll be twice. It'll be 1.5.
Have you been seeing what's going on in the Coca-Cola Racing Series recently?
I have not.
We got to catch up on that more often. Yes, so next podcast, we're going to talk more about that Coca-Cola Racing Series, because that's something I want to get into a lot more often.
Indeed.
Anything else on today's docket?
No, I might go make myself some more floor coffee here in a minute.
Floor coffee is always nice.
Yeah, it's so yummy. Is Daisy cleaning herself right now?
Yes. Oh.
Okay. You're going to get us demonetized.
Daisy, are you being a good girl? You can't hear me either, can you?
There's not a single thought behind her eyes right now.
Daisy, there you are.
There she is. Oh. I feel like the poor Apple Music listeners right now have absolutely no idea what's going on.
No, they're just Daisy scratching herself. Oh, yeah. Now she's just having a great old time. Oh, that's the ceiling. There you go.
Wow, good camera work. It.
Thank all you. Right, it's the best. Oh, yeah. Spencer Brown's getting a camera soon, so he can actually join us with video.
Oh, hell yeah. Time. Shout out to Spencer Brown. Also, shout out to our YouTube channel. We've got Formula Dream VODs up there. We've got a long-form video of Daytona Dodgeball.
That was fun.
Yeah, go check that out our YouTube. Video. That was a really good video. Go check that out if you haven't already. Y'all are missing out. That's not doing numbers like it should.
That should be doing numbers. No, it's pretty good, though. Yeah, actually, it's pretty good.
All right, now I'm going to roll the outro song, so you better say the last couple things that you want to say.
I'll see you guys all next Wednesday. Well, I guess we're going to be recording before next Wednesday, but see you all by next Friday, probably. When do we release these?
Wednesday.
See you all next Wednesday.
Yes, you will see them next Wednesday.
Good job, guys.
Yeah, excellent job, guys. So, yeah, thank you all for listening to episode 2 of the Formula Dream, not Formula Dream podcast, episode 2 of the Unnamed podcast by Central United. Noah, don't look at me like that. Daisy, so stupid. Sorry. Anyway. Thank you for listening to episode 2 of the Formula Dream. No, I did it again, of the Central United Unnamed podcast.
Are you kidding me?
I'm stupid. I'm really focused on... Okay.
No, that's rough.
The Formula Dream song is playing. God, this is the most chaotic outro.
It's not the Formula Dream song, it's the Central United song. It just plays during the Formula Dream.
Episode 2, Unnamed podcast by Central United featuring Formula Dream is over. The Daisy episode, she took over. Okay, bye!